Once again, welcome to Let's Play Something Retarded.
Yay!
We've got Portal 2, even though we said Episode 1 in the last one, but, you know, that can wait. Portal 2's short.
Liar!
I played this recently, I know what I'm doing.
Yay!
Shut up.
You shut up.
Start from the very beginning.
Oh.
Very, very beginning. Don't try to hide your excitement. It's a post-apocalyptic aperture.
Face.
Face?
Yes.
Shut up.
Good morning. You have been in suspension for 15 days. In compliance with state and federal regulations, all testing candidates in the Aperture Science Extended Relaxation Center must be revived periodically for a mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look up at the ceiling. Good. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look down at the floor. Good. This completes the gymnastic portion of your mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. There is a framed painting on the wall. Please go stand in front of it. This is art. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, stare at the art. You should now feel mentally reinvigorated. If you suspect staring at art has not provided the required intellectual sustenance, reflect briefly on this classical music. Now, please return to your bed.
Hold on a second.
Sleep. What are we doing?
I forgot to do something.
What is going on?
Subtitles.
Is it subtitles only?
Yeah, so if I did anything else, it would be like, you shoot a portal gun. You shoot a portal. I don't hear what they're saying. I don't really care about the actions that it says.
Good morning. You have been in suspension for 9999999.
Hello? Anyone in there? Hello?
Immediately. Any test.
Are you
going
to open the door
at
any time?
To have exercised his or
hello?
Extended relaxation.
Are you going to open this door? Because it's fairly urgent.
Regarding
I'll just open the door. Hello, friend. Why not open the door?
Best drawer in front of you. And write us a letter.
Could be Spanish. Could be Spanish.
That's Ricky Gervais.
Hola, amigo. Abre la puerta. Donde está... Fine. No, absolutely fine. It's not like I don't have, you know, 10,000 other test subjects begging me to help them escape. You know, it's not like this place is about to explode. Oh, God. You look good. Looking good, actually. Are you okay? Are you... Don't answer that. I'm absolutely sure you're fine. There's plenty of time for you to recover. Just take it slow.
Please prepare for emergency evacuation.
Stay calm. Stay calm. Prepare. That's all I'm saying. Prepare. It's all fine. It's fine. Don't move. I'm going to get us out of here. Oh, you might want to hang on to something. Word of advice. Up to you.
Stuff is going to start being thrown around.
No.
I like to see what appliance makes it alive.
All right, down there. Can you hear me?
Usually it's the microwave.
Hello?
Last time it was the telephone, but usually it's the microwave.
Most test subjects do experience some cognitive deterioration after a few months in suspension. Now, you've been under for quite a lot longer, and it's not out of the question that you might have a very minor case of serious brain damage. But don't be alarmed, all right? Although if you do feel alarmed, try to hold on to that feeling, because that is the proper reaction to being told that you've got brain damage. Do you understand what I'm saying at all? Does any of this make any sense? Just tell me, just say yes. Okay, what you're doing there is jumping. You just jumped, but never mind. Say apple. Apple. Okay, you know what? That's close enough. Just hold tight.
All reactor core safeguards are now non-functional. Please prepare for reactor core meltdown.
Okay, look, I wasn't going to mention this to you, but I'm in pretty hot water here. How are you doing down there? You still holding on? The reserve power ran out, so of course the whole relaxation center... sender stops waking up the bloody test subjects. Hold on, this is a bit tricky.
No, microwave.
And of course, nobody tells me anything. No, what should tell me anything?
Oh, there goes everything.
What should I be careful for? You know, about the life functions of the 10,000 bloody test subjects I'm supposed to be in charge of.
Telephone still here.
Why? Cuts. Can you see? I'm not gonna make it through, but not enough space.
Well, the fridge is still here.
And whose fault do you think it's going to be when the management comes down here and finds 10,000 flipping vegetables? Alright, no, I hit that one. Okay, listen, we should get our story straight, alright? If anyone asks, and no one's going to ask, don't worry, but if anyone asks, tell them as far as you know, the last time you checked, everyone looked pretty much alive, alright? Not dead. Okay, almost there. On the other side of that wall is one of the old testing tracks. There's a piece of equipment in there that we're going to need to get out of here. I think this is a docking station. Get ready.
Oh, there goes everything.
Good news. That is not a docking station. So there's one mystery solved. I'm going to attempt a manual override on this wall. Could get a bit technical. Hold on.
No, phone.
Almost there. Remember, you're looking for a gun that makes holes. Not bullet holes. Don't worry, you'll figure it out. Seriously, do hold on this time.
Oh, the phone's gone. We lost the phone.
Seriously. I'm down.
There we go. Now, I'll be honest, you are probably in no fit state to run this particular type of cognitive gauntlet. But at least you're a good jumper. So you got that, you got the jumping on your side. Just do your best and I'll meet you up ahead.
Hello, and again welcome to the Aperture Science Enrichment Center. We are currently experiencing technical difficulties due to circumstances of potentially apocalyptic significance beyond our control.
Drop it in.
However, thanks to emergency testing protocols, testing can continue.
I've done it before.
These pre-recorded messages will provide instructional and motivational support so that science can still be done, even in the event of environmental, social, economic, or structural collapse. The portal will open, and emergency testing will begin in 3, 2, 1.
That's Chael's new design. And the radio's hovering in front of her. Look at that. Interesting.
Cube and button-based testing remains an important tool for science, even in a dire emergency. If cube and button-based testing caused this emergency, don't worry. The odds of this happening twice are very slim.
Well, so much for that. So what do you think so far, Mr. Person who has never seen single player before?
It's pretty cool.
Did you recognize...
It hasn't really happened yet, but yeah.
Not yet, but so far we're going through the Portal 1 chambers. They're just in extreme disrepair.
If you feel liquid running down your neck, relax, lie on your back, and apply immediate pressure to your temples. You are simply experiencing a rare reaction in which the material emancipation grill may have emancipated the ear tubes inside your head.
Little simple stuff here in the beginning. Yeah, just teaching you how to do it, how to do everything. And finally, go push this one, and you're free.
Good. Because of the technical difficulties we are currently experiencing, your test environment is unsupervised. Before re-entering a relaxation vault at the conclusion of testing, please take a moment to write down the results of your test. An Aperture Science Reintegration Associate will remind you for an interview when society has been rebuilt.
Nice.
This game is hilarious.
Yeah, I've heard little bits and pieces.
Ugh.
Yeah.
If the Earth is currently governed by a manner of Animal King, Senia Cloud, or other governing body that either refuses to or is incapable of listening to it.
Heh. Well then.
Hey! You made it! There should be a portal device on that podium over there. I can't see it though. Maybe it fell off. Do you want to go have a quick look? Hello? Can you see the portal gun? Also, are you alive? That's important. Should have asked that first. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to work on the assumption that you're still alive, and I'm just going to wait for you up ahead. I'll wait 1 hour, then I'll come back, and assuming I can locate your dead body, I'll bury you. Right? Brilliant. Nice. Go team!
Go team.
See you in an hour, hopefully. If you're not dead.
I love Wheatley. He's just so incredibly stupid.
It's funny because he does have that same kind of rambling style that Ricky Gervais and you know those guys do.
Yeah.
In that show.
Emergency testing may require prolonged interaction with lethal military androids. Rest assured that all lethal military androids have been taught to read and provided with one copy of the Laws of Robots to share. Good. If you feel that a lethal military android has not respected your rights as detailed in the Laws of Robotics, please note it on your self-reporting form. A future Aperture Science Entitlement Associate will initiate the appropriate grievance filing paperwork.
Who came up with the law of robotics?
Isaac Asimov.
Is he like a legit person or just an author?
He was an author.
Oh.
I think he was a scientist too. Something. I don't know. He's a pretty famous science fiction writer though.
Why have I never heard of him?
The movie iRobot?
Yes.
Based on his story.
Oh.
This next test is very dangerous. To help you remain tranquil in the face of almost certain death, Smooth Jazz will be deployed in 3, 2, 1.
Nice. Smooth Jazz.
That's a great song. Not quite the same song.
That's what I heard.
Basic stuff is basic.
Great work. Because this message is pre-recorded, any observations related to your performance are speculation on our part. Disregard any undeserved compliments.
Look, a secret area. Well, so, sort of secret. I think. Maybe.
Maybe. Sort of.
Unreason. And lots of other numbers. I can't map. I'm taking this jug. I shall call him Jug.
Hello, Jug.
Hello, Jug. Hello. Oh. Goodbye, Jug. Take me away.
Yeah.
Yep, something like that.
Move on.
There we are.
If the Enrichment Center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space, Please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test.
Oh. Yeah. Over here. Oh, what? Only half of them appeared. But I'm still walking up them.
Uh-oh.
Whatever.
Well, weird.
What is that? Bonk. Do that. This. You can take it.
Take it. Take it away.
Well done. The Enrichment Center reminds you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts.
These loading screens are kind of lengthy.
Yeah.
Okay.
This next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through portals. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you.
Classic. It dropped. Why are you no stay still? And we one more time. Yes, we're good.
If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future, and the future starts with you.
With you. Whoa. There I am. Very odd choice of music. That may have set that too high. Oh no! I don't mean to do that. Let's pop back out of there.
And
let's go back in. Bonk.
Yay.
Okay, now we'll do that all over again. Oh god, I set it over too much. One more time. To see my face. Alright, we're good.
Good work getting this far, future starter. That said, if you are simple-minded, old, or irradiated in such a way that the future should not start with you, please return to your primitive tribe and send back someone better qualified for testing.
Nice.
Everything is so tongue-in-cheek.
Cedric, what are you doing?
To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The Enrichment Center respects your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
Hey! Oi, oi! I'm up here!
Oh, brilliant! You did find a portal cone! Do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Pop a portal on that wall behind me there, and I'll meet you on the other side of the room. Okay, listen, let me lay something on you here. It's pretty heavy. They told me never, never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail or I would die. But we're out of options here, so get ready to catch me, all right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready? One. Two. Three! That's high. It's too high, isn't it, really, that? All right, going on three just gives you too much time to think about it. Let's go on one this time. Okay, ready? One. Catch me! Catch me! Ow! I am not dead! I'm not dead! Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll show you something. You'll be impressed by this. Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching. Seriously, I'm not joking. Could you just turn around for a second? Alright, you can turn around now. Bam! Secret panel. But I open. While your back was turned. Pick me up. Let's get out. And off we go. Look at this! No rail to tell us where to go. Oh, this is brilliant. We can go wherever we want. Hold on though, where are we going? Seriously. Hang on, let me just get my bearings. Just follow the rail, actually. Oh no. Yes, hello, no, we're not stopping. Don't make eye contact, whatever you do. No, thanks, we're good. Appreciate it. Keep moving.
Will they shoot at you if you stand there?
No, it's a defective turret.
Oh, okay.
You encounter him once again later on. Awesome. That defective turret.
Oh, sick. Goodbye, Cedric.
Nobody knows who Cedric is.
Probably ought to bring you up to speed on something right now. In order to escape, we're going to have to go through her chamber, and she will probably kill us if she's awake. If you want to just call it quits, we could just sit here forever. That's an option. Option A, sit here, do nothing. Option B, go through there, and if she's alive, she'll almost certainly kill us. So, if you've got any reservations whatsoever about this plan, now would be a tremendous time to voice them.
He's supposed to say something else.
Okay, I'm gonna lay my cards on the table. I don't wanna do it. I don't wanna go in there. Don't go in there. She's off. She's off. Don't panic over. She's off. All fine. On we go. There she is. What a nasty piece of work she was, honestly. Like a proper maniac. Do you know who ended up taking her down in the end? You're not gonna believe this. A human. I know. I wouldn't have believed either. Apparently this human escaped and nobody's seen him since. Then there was a sort of long chunk of time where absolutely nothing happened. And then there's us escaping now, so that's pretty much the whole story. Don't touch it. Jump! Let's actually, look at it, that is quite a distance, isn't it? Okay, you know what? Go ahead and jump. You've got braces on your legs, so you're all set. Although no braces on your arms, though, so you're going to have to rely on the old human strength to keep a grip on the device and, by extension, me. So do really make sure you keep a grip on me. Also, a note, no braces on your spine either, so don't land on that. Or your head, no braces there. That could split like a melon from this height. So do definitely focus on landing with your legs. Ah! Oh, still held! Still being held. That's a great job. You've applied the grip, we're all fine. That's tremendous. I just looked down. I do not recommend it. I've just done it again. This is the main breaker room. Look for a switch that says escape pod. Alright, don't touch anything else. Not interested in anything else. Don't touch anything else. Don't even look at anything else. Just, well, obviously you've got to look at everything else to find the escape pod. But as soon as you look at something that doesn't say escape pod, look at something else. Look at the next thing, alright? But don't touch anything else or look at anything. Well, look at other things, but don't. You understand. Can you see it anywhere? I can't see it anyway. Tell you what, plug me in and I'll turn the lights on. Let there be light. That's God. He's quoting God.
Can you switch anything else in there?
Turning.
No, you can't do anything.
I'm probably fine, as long as it doesn't start, moving up. Now, escape pod. It's moving up. Okay, no, don't worry, I've got it. This should slow it down. makes it go faster.
Power up initiated.
Okay, don't panic. All right, stop panicking. I can still stop this. There's a password. Okay, it's fine. I'll just hack it. One problem. A.
Dropped you in the incinerator.
Incinerator.
Yeah. My brain's stupid. We know that. We've established this. Well, since I played this recently, I should not be going around saying, what do I do now? Yeah.
Cool.
But if I do, you're going to have to help me because you're Asian.
Yes, and by extension,
exactly.
We'll know what to do.
Precisely. Smashy spike blades. Boom.
Here we are. The incinerator room. Be careful not to trip over any parts of me that didn't get completely burned when you threw them down here. The dual portal device should be around here somewhere. Once you find it, we can start testing, just like all time. There it is. Hold on. There.
Okay.
You have a dual portal device. There should be a way back to the testing area up ahead.
This is the part at the end of the first game where she's like, remember when I told you I was going to drop you in the incinerator?
Yeah.
This is that part.
Once testing starts, I'm required by protocol to keep interaction with you to a minimum. Luckily, we haven't started testing yet. This will be our only chance to talk. Here, let me get that for you. Do you know the biggest lesson I learned from what you did? I discovered I have a sort of black box quick save feature. In the event of a catastrophic failure, the last 2 minutes of my life are preserved for analysis. I was able, well, forced really, to relive you killing me again and again, forever. You know, if you'd done that to somebody else, they might devote their existence to exacting revenge. Luckily, I'm a bigger person than that. I'm happy to put this all behind us and get back to work. After all, we've got a lot to do, and only 60 more years to do it. More or less. I don't have the actuarial tables in front of me. But the important thing is you are back, with me. And now I'm on to all your little tricks. So there's nothing to stop us from testing for the rest of your life. After that, who knows? I might take up a hobby. Reanimating the dead, maybe.
Uh-huh. This is where it gets fun.
Sweet.
This is where, like, you start finding secret areas. More secret areas, I think. More than usual. Yes, that. Okay. The cold boot.
Sorry about the mess. I've really let the place go since you killed me. By the way, thanks for that.
Sarcasm self-test complete.
Oh good, that's back online. I'll start getting everything else working while you perform this first simple test. which involves deadly lasers, and how test subjects react when locked in a room with deadly lasers. Not bad. I forgot how good you are at this. You should pace yourself, though. We have a lot of tests to do.
That loading screen. We just had a loading screen. And we're already at another one. So many loading screens. So many. I should just speed them up.
Loading.
That would cut like half the time.
This next test involves discouragement redirection cubes. I just finished building them before you had your, well, episode. So now we'll both get to see how they work. There should be one in the corner.
No. Damn it. I missed Wheatley. He pops up in that wall right there. And if you're quick, you can grab him.
And do what with him?
Just carry him around. Damn it!
What have you done?
Okay. Good. Get over here.
Well done. Here come the test results. You are a horrible person. That's what it says. A horrible person. We weren't even testing for that.
Nice.
Who's texting you during our very important recording? What is he saying?
He said, Mercury is the bonus clue tonight.
Okay. Freddie Mercury. Mercury thermometers.
Don't let that horrible person thing discourage you.
The only
it's
metal that is liquid at room temperature.
If it makes you feel any better, science has now validated your birth mother's decision to abandon you
what
on your doorstep.
What is the abbreviation?
I don't know. What is it? You know?
I've forgotten, actually.
I'll show you something.
Congratulate you on beating the odds and somehow
also known
managing
as quick
to pack on a few pounds.
Remember these facts for later.
Okay. I'll listen to the song.
Again.
You weren't paying attention, so I killed her.
Oh.
Sorry, Paul. You didn't even hear what she said because you're telling me those facts.
Sorry. What did she say? Was it important?
She said she congratulated you on managing to somehow pack on a few pounds.
Oh. Uh-huh. She called you fat.
Well, duh. She always calls you fat. Fat and adopted.
Fatty McFatterton.
Fatty, no parents.
Navigating these test chambers faster than I can build them, so feel free to slow down and whatever it is you do when you're not destroying this facility.
I'm gonna die. Hold on.
I'll give you credit.
Oh yeah.
I guess you are listening to me. But for the record, you don't have to go that slowly. Waddle over to the elevator and we'll continue the testing.
Waddle. That's a funny word.
Waddle.
Stop your waddling.
You are a penguin.
You're a penguin.
There we go.
This next test involves the Aperture Science aerial faceplate. It was part of an initiative to investigate how well test subjects could solve problems when they were catapulted into space. Results were highly informative. They could not. Good luck.
Ah, I gotta push this button. Hold on, I got this. I'm bad at the timing of these. Okay, no, got it. Hold on. It's difficult to do this with a keyboard and mouse. There we go.
Nice.
And hold on.
Here's an interesting fact. You're not breathing real air. It's too expensive to pump this far down. We just take carbon dioxide out of a room, freshen it up a little, and pump it back in. So you'll be breathing the same room full of air for the rest of your life. I thought that was interesting.
I've got an idea for the next recording.
Hot.
During the load screens, we shut up so that I can speed them up.
Okay.
Yeah. I won't do it for this one. I will for the next one.
Because we're talking about important things.
Exactly, precisely.
During loading screens.
No, in all seriousness.
Let's see what the next test is. Oh, advanced aerial faceplates. Well, have fun soaring through the air without a care in the world. I have to go to the wing that was made entirely of glass and pick up 15 acres of broken glass by myself.
Anyway, as I was saying, I don't like the sound of sped up voices. It's annoying.
Silence the audio there.
I know, because to do that I have to make a completely different video. You can get two achievements in here, both of which I've got, by the way. But I'll show you how to do them. First, you must do these. First, you gotta get over to the other side by doing this. Bounce. And there we go. Next, you have to do that. And press the button.
Press the button.
Oh, sorry. I'm still cleaning out the test chambers, so sometimes there's still trash in them, standing around, smelling and being useless. Try to avoid the garbage hurtling towards you.
See, they're all going into a little room over there. So, now, we just gotta get back over there. we do the exact same thing that we did with that garbage. Put a portal there, put a portal there. Now we just jump on in. One of the pieces of garbage is a radio. And to see there's a little disc right there is a radio. What?
What in the world?
Let's try it again.
That's misleading.
There's supposed to be a radio in here. It's part of the garbage. Oh, there it is.
You don't have to test with the garbage. It's garbage. Press the button again.
That starts making a weird noise. And you get an achievement for that.
Just because it's a mess.
Yeah. Look, a defective turret. It looks funny. Hold on, I have to get back over there again. I finished mine in about an hour, and he took about 3 hours. So the missiles on mine launch as well.
They launch?
Yeah.
They launch.
Well, you have to use some. You have to use some force. Next achievement you can get in here is just by doing this. Here goes the cube. Pop. Pop. And it goes right down on the button.
I like how nice. This.
Remember before when I was talking about silly garbage standing around being useless? That was a metaphor. I was actually talking about you. And I'm sorry. You didn't react at the time, so I was worried it sailed right over your head, which would have made this apology seem insane. That's why I had to call you garbage a second time just now.
He gets three extra little people with his, I just get Princess Leia.
Yeah, he gets Leia.
And she's got guns in both hands.
She's a beast.
Did you know that people with guilty consciences are more easily startled by loud noises? I'm sorry, I don't know why that went off. Anyway, just an interesting science fact. Oh, did I accidentally fizzle that before you could complete the test? I'm sorry. Go ahead and grab another one. Oh well, we have warehouses full of the things. Absolutely worthless. I'm happy to get rid of them.
There's an achievement in this one, in this room too. For leaving with the companion cube.
Ah.
Pretty simple to do.
She seems to sing a little less than she did.
To sing?
Yeah, she kind of sound like it. She's auto-tuned, but she kind of almost like she's like...
Bullshit.
Down we go. Up and over. There's the button. No! Hold on. There it goes. Drop it down again. Oh shit! Ah, wrong one.
Nice, good job.
My bad. Ah, fuck.
Uh-oh, what are you gonna do?
I put the wrong portal. Ah, Jesus. I didn't need to do any of that. Gotta do it all over again.
Nice.
Hold on. I did not mean to do that.
Good job, sir.
Ah, shut up. again. Oh, no, I gotta set this one right.
Okay.
Let's try it again. And put it on the button. Okay. Now we just simply have to do this again. No, I just gotta jump in. I missed it
the first time.
And I panicked. So that's why the other one happened. Okay. Oh yeah, she didn't. She
failed. Every test chamber is equipped with an emancipation grill at its exit, so that test subjects cannot smuggle test objects out of the test area. This one is broken. Don't take anything with you.
Screw you guys. I'm taking this thing with me.
I love you. And they are sentient, of course. We just have a lot of them.
You get an achievement for doing that. For carrying it out of the testing area.
Cool.
Let me see what the next one is, and I'll see if I would... I'll see if I'll stop recording or not.
This next test involves emancipation grills.
Oh, listen to
this.
Remember,
I told you about them in the last test area that did not have one. Oh no, the turbines again. I have to go. Wait, this next test does require some explanation. Let me give you the fast version. There. If you have any questions, just remember what I said in slow motion. Test on your own recognizance. I'll be right back.
That, nice. What she said was a random line out of Moby Dick.
Oh.
Just sped up really fast. Don't be yawning on me, sir. Why did I jump? What is going over there? It's going...
The next video we should be talking and then stop mid-sentence when this comes.
Yes. That'd be amazing. And that'll have to take place next time because now we're at chapter 3.
Yay, chapter 3.
Thanks for watching and thanks for dealing with our ship. See you next time. Bye!
Bye!
This is a recording for the sake of science. Yay, don't sound over enthusiastic or anything, you're killing me here. Loser.